Adam Lambert and his singer-songwriter friend LP is on the way. I mean, they're in the building. They are going to be taking over the airwaves from 7 on Virgin Radio Pride. Until then, it's Shivani Dave with you.
Quite a Queer Conversation. Virgin Radio Pride.
Hi, welcome to Quite a Queer Conversation with me, LP.
And me, Adam Lambert, on Virgin Radio Pride. Well, hello.
Hi. How's it going, Hi. Man? Like I said, no, long time no see.
I know. We just saw each other at a show at the Echo in Silver Lake the other night.
Yeah. It was so nice. That was fun. It's only like the second time I've been there since everything got like back, sort of.
Yeah, I haven't been there in like probably like 15 years. I hadn't been there in so long. Yeah. It was so cool to go back in. How did we meet? I don't really like. You know what? I actually, the first time I met you, I came to your show. I came to your show at the Wilton. That's how I met you officially. Yes.
I was so like, oh God, wow, really? Yeah. So yeah, that was.
I think
the first time we
knew some people, some like business people in common, and they sort of arranged that we made sure we get to say hi to each other. And your show was amazing. Yeah. Your voice is incredible. Thanks, and it was just really magical. Like you had everybody really in the palm of your hands. And like at one point I was looking around during like one of these soaring moments and everybody was like mouth agape, you know, just like,
wow. But you're the same. I mean, you know, do you abstain from drinking when you sing?
No. No, I do not.
Shoshana told me that. I don't want to tattle her out, but she's like, he does whatever he wants.
Well, yeah, I mean, look, it's like there's like a balance, you know, obviously if I'm like, if there's a lot of wear and tear, obviously I have to like pull back. I don't drink as a rule, but you know, for me,
I have five drinks after the show.
You know, but like for the Queen stuff, I always just feel like, you know what, it's rock and roll and it just kind of puts me in the spirit.
But dude, I have seen that and oh my God, I mean, like, I can't believe those notes that you're hitting and holding and just like... The attack, the execution. I'm like, wow.
Sometimes on a long tour, it's like the two shots of tequila actually get me to the note. It helps, you know?
it changes when you're in shape, doesn't it? You know, it's like there's like, in vocal shape, like it's just like the doing it more, you know? So how long is a Queen set?
I think it's like a little over an hour and a half, I think, like almost 2 hour show.
Yeah. Damn. And Freddie was just like smoking like 20 cups of beer on the piano, you know? Smoking,
like. Exactly. I could, there's no way I could drink beer for a show. I would be burping the whole time. I'd be bloated.
I always drink beer. Like when I do drink on stage. Yeah.
Well, you're lean. You're very lean. I think I would like tumble like off the stage if I started drinking beer.
In Radio Pride.
So LP, I have a question for you.
What do you got?
Was there a song that helped made you feel comfortable with your coming out?
You know,
when did you come out, by the way?
Many. What?
When did you come out?
I came out like 19. So, you know, like, you know, it's like a, it was like, kind of like my mom passed away. I was all kind of like, all right, I got to change the day. It's when I decided to do music and everything. Mm-hmm. And I just felt like I was ready to like, you know, live my own life for a second. You know, I was like, I think I like, you know, Jeff Buckley, So Real is like, you know, very like kind of like, you know, dear to me. I feel like...
he was good.
It was just so many songs. I get like, you know, it's just like albums of songs. What do you have a song that you love?
Whenever I get asked any sort of like favorites or specifics, it's always hard for me to figure it out because there's the same thing. Yeah. Like there's so many things I love, but I have a specific memory that is like, it's the gayest, most like prominent gay song. Like, I mean, I was in my car driving down the freeway to Believe by Cher. And, you know, it had just come out.
That's perfect.
I had just come out. It had just come out. I had just gotten this car. I was like, the window was down.
What kind of car was it?
It was a Cougar, a Mercury Cougar. I was like, I am in a sexy car. I'm about to graduate high school. Like, I am ready.
Virgin Radio Pride.
Did you come out to your friends first or your parents?
There was like three close friends that I came out to first. Yes.
Yeah.
And then I came out like a few months later, I think during the summer or like early the following school year, my brother was doing a something some sort of speech thing at the local university. And I went with my mom, and one of the kids did a piece about a kid being gay and like coming out to his parents, and then his parents like rejecting him for it and being religious and throwing him out. And then it was sort of a cautionary tale. Like, this could happen. You know, this poor kid in the story gets into all this, you know, terrible stuff. So on the way home, my mom was like, so we should talk. She was like, I hope that doesn't happen to you. And she basically outed me. She was like, you know, do you have a boyfriend? And I'm like, no. And she's like, well, do you want one? I was like, well, yeah.
Yeah. Like, yeah. I think that's the thing. Like, I that would have been nice. I one of the things I really was sad about, like, you know, was that I didn't get to talk to my mother about it, you know, because I just wasn't ready to deal with it in my own head. And I feel like because my dad was just like, I didn't do, you know, I was like, he must have had some kind of inkling. He's like, oh, he always brought guys home. And I dated guys, you know, he had no idea, no clue. My mother, I feel like, would have been more, more in, you know, like in tune. It would have been like, oh yeah. I mean, you know, I didn't know if you, I think she just would have been, it would have been very insightful for me more so.
Yeah, than my, you could have gotten more into like maybe some of the more like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My dad was too involved in his own, like many things, but he didn't care. like that. I always feel for people who can't talk to their parents at all, you know, about it. It's really, you know, and thank God, you know, you have your friends and community.
Yeah. All the stories that I've heard, like I feel lucky because I grew up in a house that my parents are really chill about that stuff. I mean, of course I wasn't ready to like openly talk about it either. You know, this was a different time, you know, like, yeah, you know, I'm sure you can relate. Like, it was just different. I mean, you look at what's going on now, and it's like kids are coming out in elementary school. It's like, wow.
Yeah, wow. I know. I'm kind of like, when I think about, like, I don't know if it's a good or bad, like, you know, I think everything, you know, as they say, the cliche of everything happens for a reason. But like, when I think about like friends of mine's kids, like being like seven and knowing they want to be a boy, you know what I mean? I'm like,
it's a girl. Unbelievable. You
know,
it's,
yeah. And it's like, I my life would have taken such a different path because I don't know if I had understanding parents and it was that time. I think, I mean, I was obsessed with, you know, being a boy when I was a kid. And so I would have been like, I don't know if I had like, you know, liberal parents, I might've been like, I want to do that.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. It's interesting. I think about the gender thing too. Cause it's like, it's such a different concept now. It's like, there's so many paths that one can now choose to explore. And, you know, I think all kids, no matter what your sexuality is, you go through at some point as a kid, you kind of go through some sort of gender exploration, or, you know, you're curious or you're questioning or whatever you want to call it. And it's interesting because now that there's dialogue for it and examples of it. I wonder the same thing. I mean, I love being a man, but I also love my feminine side. You know what I mean? And I love expressing it. And I don't know what shape.
Well, like, I mean, for me, I think, like, you know, the course of my life would change so drastically, you know, and I would have like discovered that I was gonna, because I didn't really know I was gonna do this with my life, like as a child or anything. This was not like really in the realm of possibility in my family. It was very like, how would you even do that? Like, that's not a viable career choice. That's a dream.
Right.
That's not like something, you know, you're be a doctor. You go to school, you get out of school.
Practical American.
Yeah. 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 So exactly. It's like, I mean, exactly. And they're horrified. After my mom passed away, and I decided, you know, to embark on this. And like, my dad was kind of like, I remember even like the last ditch, I was like working in like bars in like, you know, gay bars in Manhattan. It's like, you should be a cop.
Have you found it interesting, challenging, delightful, whatever you want to call it, dating while being a public figure? Like, how does that work for you? What's your experience with it?
I mean, you know, to be honest, my most recent relationship was the most public thing. Like, it kind of like it, like we were dating for like about a year, and then everything went ballistic for me and it in my world anyway, and got very public, you know. Mm-hmm. And I think it's difficult, you know, sometimes. I mean, it's great when it's good, you know, but when we broke up, it was like, you know, and there are many, you know, and people were like kind of thinking they know what happened from just what happened on Instagram. We didn't announce the breakup, you know what I mean? It was, you know, it was awkward, and it was my first time. I don't know. Do you go through stuff like, do you publicly announce stuff, or do you like
fans in on it? Yeah, my personal opinion on it personally is that like I've kind of gotten to a place I'm like, who cares?
Yeah, that's what I mean, think. I'm like,
there's plenty of people that I work with that might disagree with that, but I just kind of feel like, because look, I mean, the truth of the matter is that if things get out of balance or are too heavy-handed, it gets distracting from maybe what you want people to be looking at, like your music, which I fully understand. But I don't, you know, I think it's interesting too, because I think being, especially being queer and being a public figure in music, it's like, we're already sort of pioneering a certain thing anyway. You know what I mean?
We're already so public. It's like, hey, you know? Yeah.
Yeah. And I just, I've only been in a handful of relationships, and when I'm in a relationship that I'm proud of, that's working, I want to show off a little bit. I want to be like, hey, look, I'm happy. This person's making me happy. This is where I am in my life. I mean, we're so revealing in all these other areas of our lives on social media. Why shouldn't my relationship be another thing that I address? I'm not putting a big brother camera on the wall. You know what I mean? But it's like, the occasional little video of on a date or, you know, a birthday or a holiday or something. I'm kind of like,
Virgin Radio Pride.
What does it mean to you to create art that resonates with the community? What does it mean to you?
Well, I think, I don't know about you, but when I first got into, like when I auditioned for Idol and everything popped off after that, it wasn't ever a part of my initial, you know, vision to be like, oh, and I want to be a role model for gay people. Like that, it wasn't a part of my... Unfortunately, it wasn't a part of my big dream, but what I realized very quickly was like, oh, well, that's kind of what it's going to be a little bit. Like, you know, just by
default.
Proxy, you know what I mean? You know, like you're gay, you're being really open about it. So people are going to talk about it. And when I realized that there was some real need for visibility, you know, having dealt with some BS right away, I was like, oh, okay, well, then I have something to fight for. What about you?
Well, just to say again, you know, I mean, I'm not ass kissing, but like, I just like, I think you've done such a beautiful job at like, you know, being a role model for people, whether you thought so or not. And also just because of the kindness that you, emit all this time, you know what I mean? And like, you know, you're cool and everything, but you're just sweet and kind of like, it's like, you know, I don't think, and we need that, because in the past they only showed everybody being cool. You know how cool, you know, like, and I think kids and didn't have, they were just like, I can never be that because they're too cool and I'm not. But like, I feel like your openness and kindness and sweetness is just like, it just like brought it down to earth so much, you know. It's really cool.
Aww, thank you.
But
which is funny because I mean, I spent so many years just desperately wanting to be cool.
and you are.
No, so, no, I actually, mean,
that's the thing too.
But like, I feel like part of the like growth and like where I'm at now is also like understanding, I'm like, I'm actually a full-on nerd. Like I'm owning it. Like, why was I in denial of it? Like, it was almost like I was like trying to hide that part of myself. Like, I'm actually a dork. But like, I finally got to the point where I'm like, no, I'm a fucking nerd. Like in a good way. Like lean in. Like, you know. I don't know how you feel about it, but I'm like, what is cool anymore? I think that's age too. Yeah. You get a certain age and you're like, cool's not giving a shit, actually not giving a shit. Like,
and
not pretending cool, to.
Cool is kindness to me, but it doesn't have to be like, kindness doesn't have to be like, the kindness is as weakness, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, I think kindness is the biggest strength ever, you know?
Absolutely.
Like getting through this business with my kindness intact is really my biggest achievement.
I was going to ask you, who's your ultimate gay icon?
Honestly, it's Freddie Mercury.
I mean, I would have answered the same thing. So there you go.
There's nothing, he just had everything, just like we were talking about. Like, you know, he was the coolest and seemed very kind as well. You know, like, I mean, any interview I see, it's like I saw just in his, you know, even the fact that like that the woman that he spent his life with, you know, that I don't know, he's just like, he was a good dude, you know, and I feel like, and he was just like wildly talented, and he was like spearheading a movement before we knew it. He was, and he had a bunch of straight dudes going to his shows with Queen shirts on, being like,
Queen. Queen. I know. The more I learn about him, I'm just like, I mean, everyone, Roger and Brian both say like he just had like a really wicked sense of humor, which I would love to experience. And like, in a way, he was also like really ahead of his time because he was so fluid, actually. I mean, I think he was probably more involved with guys than he was with women, but there were like throughout the years, he was like, he had a couple of girlfriends, like, you know, he was very open, which I think is
like that what I perceive as like that ancient thing that I think that's how people were. Do you know what I mean? There was no like
very Roman. You know? Yeah.
Yeah. You know, like people are not going to. Yeah. I mean, you know, it just was like living his life. It's like this person. Yeah. I want to hang out with this person. I want to hang out with that person. I mean, I don't know.
Jim Radio Pride.
Oh. I got a question for you. What is your pride pet peeve?
I don't know. Short shorts. Sorry. It's too much. I don't need that much of your thigh. Male, female, I don't care who it is. It's just like a lot. Sometimes they're great. Sometimes I'm like,
I love how you went for the fashion. I was going to go like more deep, like trying to like, you know, solve world peace. But no, my thing, you know, my pride pet peeve is that I don't like within the gay community, within the queer community, because it's more than just gay, how certain members of the community will like exclude or hate on other members of the community. For example, like I feel like there's a lot of gay men that are still really anti-trans, and I'm just like, come on, guys.
Yeah, like, well, that's what we were. Yeah, like
we're all in this together. We're all just looking for our own equality and our own right to happiness. Yeah. It's not, it, you know, please be nice. So that's my pet peeve. I don't like when people are exclusionary.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I feel really like in the lesbian world, sometimes like, you know, I felt like there was like some of the older gay people were like kind of hating on younger gay people because there was just more, they had more options and stuff like that, you know? And it's just like,
yeah, the ageism is for real.
Yeah, yeah. We do have that, but like, and we, you know, but like because of you. So, you know, thank you.
But you know what? You're right. Like there, I've had little pangs of envy, you know, for the young. I'm like, wow, how nice it is for you. You know what I mean? You know, but it's also like, I realize that it's also something to really celebrate and support and enjoy from the sidelines. Like, but there are moments where I'm like, must be nice. who's a good role model today? Who would you say?
Oh gosh, you.
What about like a new artist that's like up and coming?
Troy Sivan, I think is really dope.
I'm really blown away by Lil Nas X has been. Yeah, I mean,
he's the best, I think.
It's rock and roll. Like what he's doing is rock and roll. He's pissing people off. He's shaking things up. He's making waves. Like and we haven't really had that.
Yeah. And he's so, it's just like the unapologeticness of it is really.
He is not bothered.
Not at all.
No, it's really cool.
It's not a ripple. It's really cool. Yeah, I agree.
I love the way he like stands up for himself online. And he does it all with humor. It's not taking it too seriously, which is so great.
Yeah, he's like, you know, I don't really like this using this word sometimes, but he normalizing things. And it's just really, you know, it's just because he has a special personality. I mean, you know, that's the thing. Like one of the things that like is is so important and so nice these days, as I was saying kind of about you, is that people get to really see a personality more so now, and they can see what's behind the success in a way.
It's important.
You know, yeah, people that don't have it sometimes succeed too, or just don't, you know, keep it different. And that's their thing too. They're just like, they're kind of like, you know, there's people that, I don't know, sometimes you want to see someone who's just like, doesn't give anything away. Just be like, you know, and you're like, wow.
I can't.
But what do you like best about each other? Or what would you like to tell me something nice about me?
What I love about you is that we can like laugh and be goofy and silly, but we can also go like real deep into it, which is just great. I love that.
You too. I love that too. Yeah, and
I love that.
I love just how instant you are, you know, like, I mean, I like, you know, I feel like I'm always like that with my friends. Like, it seems like I just saw you at, you know, at my experience for the songwriting session, you know, like like it's just very, you know, pick up where we leave off and just like,
that's easy.
I just love all the philanthropy you do and all the things that you do for other people.
You.
It's really deep and your foundation and everything. And it's just, I think I admire you.
Thank you. Well, thank you. I admire you too. That's the philanthropy thing has really become such a source of pride and joy, and genuinely excited by it. I mean, I went to the LGBT Center of LA last month, and it's just like, I was just so excited that this organization existed, and learning about it and the opportunity to communicate that, all of that information to my fans and around. It's really exciting. I really like it. Yeah. I didn't realize how much I would really love it, to be honest.
Yeah. Well, it's lighting you up from within, and it's cool, and everybody needs it. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. What's the first thing you would say to, what would you sell your older self? It's usually younger, but I kind of like, what would you want to tell your older self?
I like that too. I would say, ease up on the, on the drinking. it's like during the pandemic, stop doing so much drinking. I would say congrats, man. Why did you worry so much? I would say you did it. Like, you know, I did everything I set out to do already. And I'm so lucky I could like literally like die tomorrow. So I'd be like, nice. See, you worried so much. You worried so much. You didn't need to worry so much. You didn't worry so much. You're going to die early if you worry so much.
I think I would tell myself, like, see what happens when you trust yourself? Aren't you happier?
Exactly.
You trusted yourself. Good job, Lambert. Finally.
The glass is really doing for me with this.
Finally. Shut. Hey, thank you so much for being a part of our Quite a Queer Conversation with us here on Virgin Radio Pride.
Yeah. Stephen Sullivan is up next.